Now, I purchased this from a new bottle shop me and Andrew discovered, and Rob told us about it the other day as well. We originally saw it when we were leaving booths in Aycliffe. Great source for craft beer and real ale, and they're doing some good stuff over at booths. So we're leaving the car park, and I always have this instinct to find bottle shops, and it was there just off the way, just around the corner. But because traffic were bad and were bad, even worse, we drove past it, so we didn't get going. But Tuesday, remember we managed to get a pop on the train, ride the rails, and visit this bottle shop. And whilst there, picked up this beer. My brother saw it for me, and he says, "You've got to have this." So he knows I'm a big fan of tea in beer. This is a new brewery, the Steam Machine Brewing Company, and it's their afternoon tea. Weighing at 6.5%. So it's named after a long time ago when everybody knows the great where they threw all the tea in the water. So it contains Earl Grey apparently. So you should get into bergamot and some white floral. Yeah, spring flowers. Pouring pretty dark. Head retention's poor. Let's wake it up a bit. Ooh, it's a bit funky colour. Very dense in colour. Murkiness. It's getting ahead now. Single finger. But it's really murky and dark. It actually looks like a cup of tea. Slight bit of orange peel. It's almost got that like flavour of like a carrot cake or something like that. Don't smell that bad, it's got a little bit of orange cordial. But no sense of Earl Grey, but cheers. The body's pretty nice, it's quite hoppy. It's quite bitter. The body's a lot more appealing than the aroma. I'm just to try to get that Earl Grey tea feel, but moving away from that, afternoon tea, which is normally like scone and cream tea, or sometimes it's cucumber sandwiches, depends which part of Britain you're from. Let's look. Named after one of the finest of British traditions, this is an intense modern IPA. Infused with the iced quality. Earl Grey loose leaves. There's actually, if you've ever been to Yorkshire, there's a tea place in Halifax. You know, Babushka. If you get a chance, go there. Great loose teaser. Anyway, SPLA blended by one of the England's oldest tea merchants, aromas of bergamot orange and spring flowers follow this beer to a crisp Moorish finish. It's not very Moorish. The more I sip, these tea elements to it, and as you can see, it's going down smoothly. It's a lovely beer. I'm guessing it's because it's chilled, but it's kind of killed some of it. But with it being an IPA, it shouldn't have done that bad. But the body's fine, death is nice, a little bit of orange, carrot cake, and it's a lovely beer. going nice smoothly. 6.5, the alcohol is unwell. Will this be my first and last beer from Steam Machine? No, because there's not really, the only that's putting it off is the body and off the appearance of, and I'll say it's the appearance that's putting it off, but everything else is on mark. I wish we got more tea elements to it, but other than that, yeah, nice beer. I paid £2.75 at Fuggle and Golden. The prices weren't that bad in there either. But yeah, I probably would try more from Steam Machine. And now I know where I can buy some. Check out Fuggle and Golden, check out Steam Machine. You take care. Goodbye.